This is his schematic that he drew. I think we're close. Of the helmet I'm making for my mini, right? It's better. We'll get to those a little bit later. Maybe sand them down. But essentially, for my first helmet, not bad, right? Not bad. Pretty simple. Paint, get prime, you know what I'm saying? Pretty simple. Like that. Now, what's important when you're working with tools and foam, as you notice here, we're gonna get this nice rounded out edge here to go on the top of this level here. We're gonna sand this off, round it out. But always remember, safety is paramount. Oh yeah, baby. Let's begin. Ending up with something along these lines. Just a little bit of wing action. I added some rivets to give that detail effect. And I added some ventilation burns. Thought I'd do it first off with the sander, but I was like, fuck it, let's just get to the burn tool. Reminds me, always use the right tool for the right job. If you got a lot of tools, you can do a lot of stuff. And I feel like, since there's so many different pieces, you'd be like, oh look, I got this whole little box of stuff, I'm gonna stick to my favorite. Doesn't necessarily work that way. If you open and expand your mind out in different ways that you can create a whole new genre, or not a whole new genre, but a whole new dynamic to your project. The effects can be greater, some more beautiful, the fun things you can do. And, of course, you know, rock and roll. It's up to you. It's your art, your craft. Crazy idea that I had a little while back. I always knew that something was going to happen with this particular item, and I figured today would be the day. So I took this old broom handle that a cousin of mine broke a little bit ago, and so I decided to put it aside. Now, these little tendrils here, it's kind of similar to like porcupine needles, right? I'm going to use it like hair. Check it out soon. Now what I recommend first, wash the broom. Okay, you never know what was in there that you've been sweeping up. However, it's once you kind of get it washed and maybe you throw a little bleach on it just for the sake of depending on where it is, you can start applying it to your cosplay. Here we go. So what you end up with is this black frosted hairline here, which will go perfectly. Now with another peanut butter vinyl, this is a little shim karma. It's kind of frosted for another stage too, and then I'm gonna go back over with the spray paint for a little black finish. So then you'll end up with something like this. I know it looks a little crazy, but the finished product will be a little fun. And plus, hey, it's a broom.
Leave him alone!
No, what the fuck?
Leave him alone!
Go, get the fuck out of here!
Okay, so we are test fitting the helmet my son is going to have. I finished a little bit of the paint job. I tried to go with this little detail, this little diamond details. Didn't come out the way I was looking for, but still got a kind of a cool effect to it. We'll see. Still a lot of work to do. I have yet to actually glue this, as you can literally see. And yeah, let's keep rocking. Very proud and happy about this first installment of a helmet. We'll pull up some light so we can get some better quality video. However, not too bad. So, I was supposed to use some contact cement, didn't have it. So hot glue was the way, and it definitely is not the best for what I was trying to do overall. But if I didn't have it, it wouldn't have came out altogether. So praises to that. Ooh. I think my son might like it.